Good morning children, good morning class 6 students. So in this video I will cover new chapter number 3, maths, playing with numbers. So I have completed the previous two chapters, so in this video I will cover the introduction part of chapter number 3, playing with numbers. So here we will know about the numbers. Introduction. Suppose John uncles gave him 24 muffins to distribute among his friends. This means John has 24 divide 1 is equal to how much? 24 muffins. Okay. So you can see with the picture. He want to equally distribute it among 6 children. How will he do that? He want to distribute among how many children? 6 children. So total muffin is how much? 24. So how you will do this? How you will distribute among them equally? You have to do what? Divide, isn't it? So 24 divide 6 is how much? 4. That means 24 is equal to now 6 into 4. If 24 divide 6 is equal to 4, then 6 multiply 4 will be how much? 24. 6 multiply 4 is how much? 24. That means each children got how much? 4 muffins. Okay, one children got 4 muffins. Now what if 2 more children come to his place? Only 6 was there. Now again 2 more children came and joined him. So if there is 2 more children joined together, so that total muffins was 24, and that muffin will be divided among how much now? 8, isn't it? How much? So if 2 students increase, that means total how many children now? 8 children. Now 24 divide 8 is how much? 3, because 3 into 8 is 24. So 24 divide 8 is 3. That means 1 children got how many muffins? 1 children got 3 each. Now suppose 4 more children visit his place at the same time. Can he distribute muffin equal among them? Now 4 more came. It was already 8, isn't it? If 4 more will add there, then total will be how much? Total will be 12. Now, yes, we can, isn't it? Because 24 divide 12 is how much? 2. That means 12 into 2 is equal to how much? 24. Now, how much they got? They got 2 each. They got one children got 2 muffins each. Now, from this calculation, we can see that 24 can be written as the product of 2 numbers in different ways. Means 24 can be written in product of 2 different numbers, isn't it? So 24 can be written as 12 into 2. In the same way, again we got what? 8 into 3. So again one more we got, that is what? 6 into 4. So 24 can be written as multiples of 2 numbers. So you can see 24 equal to 6 into 4, 24 equal to 8 into 3, again 24 equal to 12 into 2. This means all this number 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 are exactly divisor of 24. They are exactly divisor or not? Because there is no remainder. While dividing, there was no muffins left over, isn't it? All are divided exactly. That means 2, 3, 4, 6, 8 and 12 are exactly divisor of 24. So these numbers are called what? Factors. So these all numbers, which number? 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12. These numbers are called factor of 24. So these are the factor of 24. So now we will study further about the factor. What is factor? A factor of a number is defined as the number which is an exact divisor of that number. Suppose we want number 12. Think about the number you can multiply together to get 12. So different number which we will multiply together and we will get 12. Which are the number? So they are 3 into 4, 12, 2 into 6, 12, again 1 into 12, 12. So these are the number, isn't it, when you are multiplying together and you are getting number 12. This shows that 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12 are the factor of whom? Factor of 12. So these are called factor. So I will explain again. A factor of a number is defined as the number which is an exact divisor. Okay, it should be exact divisor of that number. Suppose we want number 12. Think about the number that you can multiply together to get 12. So which number we can multiply together and we will get 12. So that number are called factors of 12. Now the important fact of factor. So these are the important fact of factor. The number 1 and the number itself are always factor of that. So suppose I will say number 12. Okay. The number 1 and the number itself are always factor of that number. So what it means? Suppose 12. So the number 1. What? 1. And the number itself. Number itself is what? 12. That means 1 and 12 are always the factor of that number. Suppose I will ask factor of 6. Okay, factor of 6. Then 1 and 6 will also be a factor of 6 always. Understood? Now the next point is, every factor is less than or equal to the given number. So every factor, suppose I will say factor 12. Okay, again I will say 12. Then all the factor will be less than 12 or equal to 12, but it will be not greater than 12. Okay, it will be, every factor is less than or equal to that given number. Suppose 12. Now the factor of 12 will be always less than or equal to 12. It will be not greater than 12. So 13 cannot be a factor. 13 cannot be a factor of 12. Okay, 13 cannot be a factor of 12 because all the factor will be less than or equal to that number. Now the third point, every factor of a number divide the given number exactly. So every factor of a number, suppose 2 and 3 is the factor of 12. That means 2 and 3 will be exactly divisible with 12. 2 and 3 will be exactly divisible with 12. If it is not divisible exactly, then 2 and 3 will not be a factor of 12. Now the last point is, the number of factor of a given number are finite. So means finite means it is countable. Okay, means for any given number there will be a finite factor. Finite means it is countable, so there will be a definite value only. So infinite means uncountable, there will be so many values which is uncountable, but finite means it is countable. Now come to common factor. So what is common factor? When two or more number have the same factor. Okay, when two or more factor, if there is two number or three number, from there if they have the same factor, that factor is known as the common factor. Now I will give one example. Let's find put common factor of 6 and 18. First we will find the common factor of 6 and 8. So what are the factor of 6? 6 equal to 1 into 6 and 6 equal to 2 into 3. So what are the factor? 1, 2, 3 and 6. So the factor of 6 is 1, 2, 3 and 6. Now 18. So 2 multiples number, 18 equal to 1 multiply 18, again 18 equal to 2 into 9, again 18 equal to 3 into 6. So only this much are the multiples. Therefore factor of 18 will be 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 8. Now you can see from this and from this factor which are common. Here 1 is common, isn't it? Now again 2 and 2, 2 is common, then again 3 is common. Now you can see 6 and here also 6 and here also 6. So which are common here? 1, 2, 3 and 6. Hence common factor of 6 and 18 are, what are the common factor? Now which are common value here? 1, 2, 3 and 6. These 4 numbers are common factor of 6 and 18. Hope you have understood. Now the next point will be, perfect number. So what is perfect number? What number I'll call as perfect number? A perfect number is defined as a number for which sum of all this factor is equal to twice the number. Now multiples. So I will explain about multiples. Suppose 6 eggs are present in one container. How many eggs must be there in 4 such container? So in one container there are how many eggs? 6 eggs. If there will be 4 more container, okay? How many container? 4 more container. And each container contain how many eggs? 6 eggs, isn't it? So what will be the total number? What you will do? You will do multiply, isn't it? 6 multiply 4. What you will do? 6 multiply 4. No, 6 into 4 is how much? 24. So there will be 24 total egg if there is a 4 container of 6 egg. Now if there are 7 container, then number of egg in 7 container will be how much? In one container, how many apple or egg is there? 6, isn't it? Now 6 into 7, how much you will get? You will get 28. 6 into 8, you will get 28. So to find a total number of egg, here you have multiplied the number of egg in one container. Means in one container, how many are there? So with that, you will multiply with the container. So this is the concept of multiples. Okay, these are called what? Multiples. Now I will explain about a common multiples. What is this common multiple? So what it mean by common multiples? The common multiples of two or more numbers are the multiples that are common to every given number. So they are common to every given number. Let's find the common multiples of 4 and 6. Now first you will find the multiples of 4 and multiples of 6. After that you will find which numbers are common. Multiples of 4 means what? Just you can write the table of 4, and for 6 just you can write the table of 6. So you can write in this way: 6 into 1, 6, again 12, 18, 24, isn't it? Then 30, 36, 42, 48, 54 and 60. These are the tables of 6. Now tables of 4, 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28 and 32, 36, 40. Now these all are the tables of 4 and 6. Now we find first 10 multiples. We found first 10 multiples of 4. So these are the first 10 multiples of 4. And these are the first 10 multiples of 6. Now you can see from here which are common. Now you can see 12 here and 12 here also, isn't it? So here you can see 12 and 12. And the next number which is common here, 24, 24. Again next number which is common here, 36 and 36. Now is there any other common number? No. So from the first 10 multiples, how many common multiples we got? We got 12, 24 and 36. Now these three numbers are common multiples of 4 and 6. Now I will explain prime and composites number. So prime number. So what is prime number? The numbers other than 1 whose only factor are 1. Okay. Means other than 1 except 1 whose only factor are 1 and the number itself are called prime number. Means who have only factor 1 and the number itself. Suppose 5. So for 5, what are the factor? Only 1 into 5 is equal to 1 into 5 is equal to what? 5. Is there any other number which will make 5? Is there any other two number when you will multiply and you will get 5? No, isn't it? So the number which have only 1 and the number itself as a factor, that number is called what? Prime number. Now 5 is what? Prime number. Now again suppose 3. Now only 1 into 3 will make 3. is there any other number which you will get multiply and you will get 3? No, isn't it? So these numbers are called what? Prime number. Now next, composite number. A composite number is defined as a number having more than two factor. What? Having more than two factors. So a number which have more than two factor is called what? Composite factor. For example, factor of 9. So what are the factor of 9? 1, 2 and 3. Okay, 1, 2 and 3. Because 1 into 9 will give what? 9. Isn't it? 1 into 9 will give 9. Again, 3 into 3 will give you 9. Is there any other number that you will get 9? No. So only 1, 3 and 9, these three numbers are factor of 9. So these types of numbers are called what? Composites number. Now again you can see, therefore factor of 14. What are the factor of 14? 1, 2, 7, 14. So what are the factor? 1, 2, 7, 14. Therefore it is a composites number. So for any number, if there is a factor more than 2, okay, more than 2, then that is called what? Composites number. Important notes. 1 is neither prime nor composite number. So 1 is not prime also and not composite also, okay. So keep it mind, 1 is not a prime and not a composite number. Now any whole number greater than 1 is either a prime or composite number. So any whole number which will be greater than 1 will be what? Either a prime or composite. If it is composite, then that it will be not a prime number. And if it is prime, then it will not be a composite number. So other than 1. So 1 will be not prime also, 1 will be not composites also. Now the next point is, now co-prime number. What is co-prime number? Any set of number which do not have any other common factor other than 1. Means if you will compare two numbers, okay, if you will compare two numbers and you will not get any common other than 1, only 1 will be there common and there will be no any other common factor, that type of number is called co-prime number. Now I will say the important points of co-prime number, means important property of co-prime number. Properties of co-primes are: all prime numbers are co-prime to each other. Okay, all prime numbers. So how many prime numbers are there? All prime number will be co-prime to each other. And second, any consecutive whole number are always co-prime. So consecutive whole number means what? Suppose 26, then next will be 27. So like that number, any consecutive two number will be always co-prime. Now sum of any two co-prime number is always co-prime. Again, when you will do sum of any two co-prime, that number will be again a co-prime. Fourth point, co-prime numbers need not be a prime number. So a number which is not prime number, that can also be a co-prime number. So the next point will be twin primes. Twin primes are a prime of which differ by two. First few twin primes are, means which difference, okay, there is two prime number and if you will take out their difference, the difference will be two. That type of numbers are called twins prime. For 3 and 5, so the difference of 3 and 5, 5 minus 3 is how much? 2, isn't it? So different will be 2. In the same way, 5 and 7, again 11 and 13, 17 and 19, these all numbers are what? Twins prime, whose difference is what? 2. These are called what? Twins prime. Test for divisibility of numbers. This means how we can come to know that any number is divided by 2, any number will be divided by 3, how we will come to know. So there is a rules to find out the divisibility test. Now divisibility by 2. Now how you will say that by looking at the number, that number will be divisible by 2 without doing division, how you will find? If the number ended with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, it is divisible by 2. Means any number whose nth number will be 2, 4, 6, 8, 0, and these types of number will be what? Divisible by 2. For example, 28. So 8, what is the unit place here? 8. And the next 54, what is the unit place? 4. You will see only the unit place. If the unit place is 2, 4, 6, 8, or 0, then that number will be divisible by what? That number will be divisible by 2. So this is the divisibility of 2. Now next will be 3. Now divisibility by 3. How you will find out that number is divisible by 3 or not? If the sum of the digit of any number is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. Means sum. What is it? Sum. If the sum of that given number, if suppose for example 429. So if you will add all this number, 4 plus 2 plus 9, you will get how much? 15. Now 15 is divisible with 3, isn't it? 15 is divisible with 3. So this number will be divisible by 3. Means when you will do sum of that number, and if that sum number is divisible by 3, that means you can say that that number is divisible by 3. Now 429 is divisible by 3. Here divisibility by 4. Now how you will come to know that any given number will be divisible by 4? If the last 2 digit of any number are divisible by 4. So only you will see the last 2 digit. Then that number is divisible by 4. Example 629. So what is the last 2 digit here? Last 2 digit are 28. Now 28 is divided with 4. How many times? 7 times. Only you will see the last 2 digit. If the last 2 digit is divisible by 4, that means that whole number will be divisible by 4. Therefore, 628 is divisible by 4. So this is for divisibility by 4. Now the next is divisibility by 5. Now you can see here, if the digit in the ones place of a number is 5 or 0, means one place means the last digit, okay? The last digit is 5 or 0, then it is divisible by 5. Now for example, 95. So 95 is end with 5, isn't it? So this number will be divisible by 5. Again, second example, you can see, what is it? 680. Now 680 means, what is the last digit? Unit place is what? 0. So 680 will be divisible by 5. Next is divisibility by 6. What is the definition here? If a number is divisible by 2 and 3. So for 6, what you have to do? You need to see for 3 and 2. If any number will be divisible by 3 and 2, then that number will be divisible by 6. So understood this? To check the divisibility of 6, the number should be divisible with both 2 and 3. Now for example, 246. What is the last digit? 6. So this number is divisible by 2, isn't it? Because n is 6. Now again for the 3, how you will do? You need to sum all the number. 2 plus 4 plus 6 is equal to 12. Now we can say 12 is divisible by 3. So 246 will be divisible by 6. Because 246 divisible with 2 and 3, so all this number will be divisible by 6. So you can write down these notes. Now next is divisibility by 8. A number is divisible by 8 if the number formed by its last 3 digit is divisible by 8. Now for 4, what was the rule? You have to see the last 2 digit, isn't it? But for 8, you have to see the last 3 digit. Now for example, 2544. So what is the last 3 digit? 544. 200, 544 is the number. So last 3 digit is 544. So if this 3 digit, 544, will be divisible by 8, then you can say 2544 will be divisible by 8, okay? Now, so you can see here, 544 divided with 8 is equal to 68. That means this last 3 digit is divisible by 8. Therefore, 2544 is divisible by 8. Now, the divisibility test of 9. A number is divisible by 9 if the sum of its digit is divisible by
9. So this is just like 3. You have to sum all the digit, and if all the digit will be divisible by 9, then that number will be divisible by 9. For example, 42,471. If you will sum all the digit, 4 + 2 + 4 + 7 + 1. So what is the value? 18. Now you can say 18 is divisible by 9. Therefore, 42,471 is divisible by 9. Now next is divisibility by 10. So I think everybody know the divisibility by 10. If the last digit will be what? 0, isn't it? A number, sorry, so here a number is divisible by 10 if it end with a 0. So any number whose end is 0, that number will be divisible by what? 10. Now come to divisibility by 11. A number is divisible by 11. Now divisibility by 11. A number is divisible by 11 if the difference of the sum of alternate, okay, keep it mind this one, alternate digit is 0 or a multiples of 11. Now you have to do the difference of the sum of alternate number. Sum of alternate number means alternate numbers. So first what is here? 9, isn't it? Then next 7. So you will skip 7. That means 9 and 2 and 7 and 4 you will add. Alternate. It is written the difference of the sum of alternate number. So sum of alternate number, 9 plus 2 is how much? 11. Isn't it? 9 plus 2 is 11. In the same way, 7 plus 4. 7 plus 4 is also how much? 11. Now if you will do difference, difference means what? Minus, isn't it? If you will do minus, 11 minus 11 is how much? 0. So if you will add the alternate digit and difference is 0 or a multiples of 11, then that number is called what? That number will be divisible by 11. So understood? You will add the alternate digit, and if you will add and you will do difference, if you will get 0 or any number that is divisible by 11, then that number will be divisible by 11. So here difference will be how much? 0, isn't it? So difference is 0. Therefore, 9724 is divisible by 11. So in this chapter, we will do the divisibility test till 11, okay? So the next point will be highest common factor. I think you have heard this HCF, isn't it? What is it? Highest common factor, HCF. The full form is highest common factor. So we will say only HCF. HCF of two or more given number is highest. So HCF of two or more given number is what? Highest of their common factor. If there is two number, and what will be their HCF? HCF will be their highest common factor. Which number will be highest common factor? That number will be the HCF of the given number. It is also known as greatest common divisor. So HCF is also known as greatest common divisor. To find the HCF of two or more numbers, we can use any of the following methods. So to find a HCF, there are two methods, okay? Common factor method and prime factorization method. So common factor method means what? You will find out all the commons and you will say which is the HCF number. And the another is by doing prime factorization method. Now I will explain one by one. Common factor method. Let's find the HCF of 18, 24 and 42. With example, I will explain 18, 24 and 42. First, find all the factor given number individually. So, individually means 1, 1, 1. You will do separately 18, 24 and 42. Now, factor of 18. What are the factor of 18 here? 1, 2, 3, 6, 9. 18. So I have already explained how to find a factor. So the factor of 18 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 18. Now factor of 24. What are this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24. These are the factor of 24. Now factor of 42. What are the factor of 42? We got 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 14, 21 and 42. These are the factor of 24. Now you will find the common factor. So which are the common factor? You can see here 2, 3 and 6. These all numbers are what? Common factor of both this given 3 numbers. So from here, which is the highest? 6. Which is highest number? 6. So ACF of, so ACF of 18, 24 and 42 will be what? 6. Because the highest common factor is what? 6. So this method is called what? Common factor method. Now I will explain about prime factorization method. Now prime factorization method. So I will explain prime factorization method with example. So let's find the ACF of 27 and 45. First we have to find the factor of 27. So how you will find in prime factorization method? You can see here 27. Now the smallest prime number is what? 2, isn't it? So you will see for 2. If 2 will not divide with 27, then next prime number is what? 3. So 3 nines are 27. How many times? 9 times. Next again 3. How many times will make 9? 3 times. So 3 threes are 9. Again next 3 ones are 3. So these are the factor prime factor of 27. 3, 3, 3 and 1. So 27 will be equal to 1 into 3 into 3 into 3. Now next we will find 4, 5. So 45 will be not divisible with 2. 2 is also prime number, but 45 is not divisible with 2. So next number will be what? 3. So if you will see 45, you will divide with 3. How much you will get? 15. 15 into 3 is 45, isn't it? Now next again 15 will divisible by 3. So 3, 5 are 15. Now this 5 will be not divisible by 2 and 3. This 5 itself is a prime number. So 5 will divide with only 5. So 5, 1 are 5. So what we got here? 3, 3, 5 and 1. Now you can see what we got. 45 equal to 1 multiply 5 multiply 3 multiply 3. Now multiply all the factor which appear in both the list. So what we got for 27? We got 3 into 3 into 3. And for 45, what we got? 3 into 3 into 5. So that is which are common here now. You can see 3, 3, 2, 3 and here also 2, 3 and here 2, 3. This 2, 3. So 3 into 3 is common. So 3 into 3 is how much? 9. So 9 is, therefore 9 is ACF of 27 and 45. So one question, find the ACF of the following numbers. So this is your homework, 18, 54 and 81. You can use the common factor method and also prime number method. You can use any one of them. Now come the next point will be ACF. So here the next is lowest common multiples, that is LCM. LCM, the lowest common multiples LCM of two or more given number is the lowest or small or least of their common multiples. So from the common multiples, the lowest multiples, you have to understand this multiples. Okay, multiples means with all the common factor you will do multiply, is the lowest of their common multiples. If two numbers are co-prime, then the LCM is the product of the two number. If the two number is co-prime, okay, co-prime means what? If there will be only one as a factor. What is co-prime? Where only one will be their common factor of both the number, that type of number, the LCM will be their multiples. Okay, suppose 7 and 3.
Find the LCM of 7 and 3. So for 7, what are the factors? 7 into 1, only 1 and 7 is factor. And for 13 also 1 and 13 is factor. And here which is common? Only 1 and 1 is common. So of this type number, the LCM will be their product. Product means 7 into 13. So LCM will be what? 91. If the two number is co-prime, then their LCM will be their product. Now to find LCM using common multiples method, how you will do? Common multiples method. Find the lowest common multiples means LCM of the number 8, 12 and 18. Solution, you will list the multiples of 8. You will write all the multiples, not factor, okay? Multiples. Multiples means what? The table, isn't it? The 8 table you will write. We have written all 8 table here. Again, list the multiples of 12. So you will write some multiples of 12. 12 ones are 12, 12 are 24, 36. In this way you will write down. Now list the multiples of 18. So 18 ones are 18 and 18 to the 36. 18 threes are 54. 18 fours are 72. In this way you will write some tables of multiples of 18. After that you will see which is the first common, means smallest common. Here which are common? 48 is here, 48 is here, but 48 is not in 18, isn't it? So 48 will be not common. Now next you can see 72, 72 and 72. So 72 is in the multiples of 3 digit, isn't it? For 8 also, for 12 also, for 18 also. That means 72 will be the LCM of whose? LCM of 8, 12 and 18. So this is called the method of common multiples method. So you will write down the table and the number which is the first multiples, okay? The first common multiples will be the LCM. Now next by prime factor method, okay? Common prime factor methods. LCM, find the LCM of the number 36, 48 and 72. So you have to find the LCM of 36, 48 and 72. So how you will do? You will write like this, 36, 48 and 72. So here you can see 2, isn't it? 2 is divisible with all the numbers. 2 18s are 36, 2 24s are 48 and this one 72 will divide with 36. Now again 18, 24 and 36 will divide with again 2, isn't it? Now again 9, 12, 18. This number will be again divisible by what? 2. 9 will remain as 9, okay? 12 will divisible with how many times? 6 times. Again 18 will divisible with 2 times. If the number, if any number is not divisible, then you will write down the same number. Now next 3. 3 will divisible with 9 how many times? 3 times. Again with 3, 1 time. Again with 3, 9 times. Now 3, 1, 3. So this number will divisible will what? 3. Now 3, 1 and 1 will come down, same 1 and 3, 1 time. So what are the LCM here? LCM will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. So you have to multiply all this, okay? Because LCM means least common multiples. Multiples means what? Multiply. That's why you have to multiply all this value and you will get how much? 144. 142. The LCM is 144. So the introduction part of this chapter 3 is complete here. In my next video, I will come with the exercise of this chapter. Hope you have enjoyed my video. And if you like my video, then please do like and subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye and see you soon in my next video.